Hello everyone, welcome back to Act of Learning. Our discussion in this video is about a nice problem in geometric probability. Consider an acute angle triangle. Let's choose a point randomly inside this triangle and draw a line from that point in a random direction until it meets an edge. Our question now is to find the expected length of this line segment. That is, if we repeat this procedure over and over again, what will be the average length of this line segment? Before we proceed, this video will be slightly math heavy, though we will still avoid evaluating complicated integrals and make the solution as intuitive as possible. The following may be considered as a sort of prerequisite for this video. First, given a random variable x with a probability density function f of x, the expected value of a function g of x will be the integral of g of x times f of x. Specifically, if x were uniformly distributed in the interval 0 to 2 pi, then the expected value of g of x will be 1 by 2 pi times the integral of g of x from 0 to 2 pi. Similarly, if a point P with coordinates x, y is uniformly distributed in a triangle, then the expected value of g of P will be the double integral of g of P times dy dx divided by the triangle's area. Second, integral of a secant function from 0 to tan inverse of m equals the inverse hyperbolic sine of m. Finally, the law of total expectation. That is, if we know the distribution of x and the expected value of a random variable y for a given value of x, then we can find the expected value of y using the same formula above. Back to our problem. We can fix the triangle in a coordinate system with vertex B at the origin and the side BC along the x-axis. Let D, E and F be the foot of the altitudes from A, B, C respectively, and let HA, HB, HC be their corresponding lengths. If we let L as the length of the random segment, then this length is some function G of the random point x, y and the random angle T from the x-axis. Now the expected length is given by the triple integral of the function g over the points on the triangle and the angle t. That already looks crazily complicated. On top of that, we don't even know what the function g is, and by the looks of it, it does not seem any simpler. It is not even clear at this point whether this integral can be solved in closed form. If you find this problem interesting, you can pause the video here and give it a try before proceeding further. It is often said that conditioning is the soul of statistics. With that in mind, we are going to solve this seemingly hard problem by solving a series of simpler problems. As a first step, consider the same problem in a simpler setup. We choose a point randomly inside the triangle and draw a line perpendicular to the base B from this point. We start by finding the expected length of this random perpendicular line. If the coordinate of the random point is x, y, then it is clear from the geometry of the figure that the length of this perpendicular line is just y. Therefore, the expected length is given by the double integral of y over the points on the triangle ABC. This double integral is deceptively simple. While this integral is written as an expression for some expected value, from the perspective of mechanics, it is the y coordinate of the center of mass of the triangle. It is a classical result that the centroid of a triangle is located at a distance that is a third of its height from the base. This fact was used by Archimedes to find the area of the parabolic segment. That readily gives the result of this integral to be AD by 3. For the second setup, let M be a point between D and C. We again choose a point inside this triangle and draw a line parallel to AM towards base BC. Let P be a random point and Q be the point where the random line meets the base BC. Then the average length in this setup is the double integral of PQ over the triangle ABC. Letting T as the angle between AM and altitude AD, it is clear that PQ equals Y by cos T. Using the result from setup 1, it is quite easy to see that the integral evaluates to AD by 3 cos T, which is the same as AM by 3. Moving on, we are again given a point M between A and D. We choose a point inside this triangle and draw a line parallel to AM, but this time away from BC. We solve this case by considering two cases depending on whether the point lies inside triangle MAB or triangle MCA. The probability of the point being in either of these triangles is given by the ratio of their respective areas with the area of the full triangle. Let's say the point lies inside triangle MAC. What we now want is the expected length of a line drawn parallel to MA towards side AC in triangle MCA. But this is just our second setup, with the given point being one of the vertices itself. Then from the previous result, we know the expected length is AM by 3. By symmetry, the same reasoning applies to triangle MAB as well. Using these results, the expected length in this setup is again MA by 3. Our next setup combines both the cases above. Given a point M between A and D, we choose a point randomly inside the triangle and draw a line parallel to AM, either towards BC with some probability P or away from BC with probability 1 minus P. From what we have seen so far, we know that the expected value are the same irrespective of the line being towards or away from BC. Therefore, regardless of what P is, the expected length in this setup still remains at AM by 3. In terms of the angle T between AD and AM, this expected length can be written as AD by 3 cos T or HA by 3 cos T. We have made some good progress here. We now know that the expected length of a line drawn by picking a point randomly in a triangle and parallel to a given line AM is a third of the length of AM. In case you feel a little fuzzy about the details, now is a good time to pause the video and ponder over our discussion so far. For our fifth setup, we choose a point randomly and draw a line such that the angle T between this line and the altitude AD is uniformly distributed in the interval between 0 to tan inverse of CD by AD. The expected value in this case is 1 by tan inverse of CD by AD times the integral of HA by 3 cos T over the given interval. Knowing that the integral of secant T is the inverse hyperbolic sine of tan T, the expected value of our fifth setup with segment CD simplifies to HA by 3 times the inverse hyperbolic sine of CD by AD divided by tan inverse of CD by AD. For the next setup, we extend this angle to cover the whole of angle A. That is, we choose a point inside the triangle ABC and draw a line such that the angle T between the random line and the side AC is uniformly distributed between 0 to angle A. This is simple. Just divide the interval along the altitude AD. The expected length of setup 6 with vertex A then will be tan inverse of BD by AD by angle A times the expected value from setup 5 with segment BD plus tan inverse of CD by AD by angle A times the expected value of setup 5 with segment CD. After some boring simplifications, this can be written compactly as HA by 3 times 1 by angle A times the inverse hyperbolic sine of A into P minus A divided by P into S minus A, where P and S are the perimeter and the semi-perimeter of the triangle respectively. We now solve the original problem. We choose a random point and draw a line from this point in a random direction until it meets the edge of the triangle. Since the line can be extended in any direction now, the angle will be uniformly distributed from 0 to 2 pi. Based on our results so far, we can simplify this case by dividing the range into the three angles of the given triangle. Each of these subcases is the same as that of setup 6 on the three vertices of the triangle. Thus, we finally get the expected length with a very symmetric and closed form solution. And that is the result I wanted to share with you in this video. Before we conclude, here is a little challenge. We found this result assuming that the triangle is acute. What about obtuse triangles? Do you think anything changes in this formula? If yes, do share it with us in the comment section below. Hope you enjoy the discussion. See you in the next video.